Hi there, Grant Hiller from Spectrami, joined today by Dennis from Peer Software. Hi Dennis.
Hello.
We've done a couple of videos already about some of the use cases of Peer Software and some of the areas that we can cover and some of your messaging for 2019. In this one, we want to talk about collaboration. Mm-hmm. Collaboration obviously means working with others.
Correct.
And what we want to do is kind of illustrate how Peer Software can deal with collaborating on documents. And not just the standard Microsoft Word documents. This could be an AutoCAD diagram, or you know, pretty much any file that needs to be accessed by multiple people from multiple locations.
Yeah, the important thing is the application you're going to use for collaboration have to support the file logging.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's based on your application somehow. For example, if you try to collaborate with text documents, this will obviously not work. But for AutoCAD, Office files, more traditional stuff you work with different people on, it will work.
So as a rule of thumb then, let's say if there is a file lock on one system, so multiple users accessing the same file on one system, then Peer Software will support the same mechanisms across multiple infrastructures and multiple locations.
Yes.
Perfect. So can we draw that up?
Yes, sure.
Excellent.
So maybe you have watched our last video where you've seen we have our central management server here, or our central management console called the Peer Management Center.
Yep.
And we have a Windows file server here in the UK, and we have a NetApp system in Germany.
Okay.
So let's add some additional systems here. For example, let's add an EMC Isilon.
Okay, yep.
And like with the NetApp system, we cannot install our agent directly on an EMC system. So again, we need a small Windows system here that can connect to the API of the EMC.
So as we talked about before, that could be sat of a virtual machine. It's really only to communicate with the API on the box.
That's correct.
Okay, yeah. Clear.
So for NetApp, we went with the F policy API. For EMC, it is a CEE framework.
Okay, yep.
And then after that, the agent will connect to the PMC, and you have a cert agent listed in the PMC.
Perfect.
The same goes, for example, with the Nutanix files. And I bet you already guess.
I guess where you're going. Obviously, you can't install software directly on the Nutanix box, so once again, we put the agent on a VM.
Yes,
okay.
Absolutely.
Yep.
You got it.
Good.
So now we have four different systems. Obviously, it can be more, yeah, but for this example, let's start with four different systems. And what we're doing now is we're not only replicating our files between all of these different systems, we are able to look into the file open table of the operating system and replicate this information to other locations.
Okay, so it's lock status
in
this scenario.
So if someone opens an Excel sheet here, in the location in the UK, this information will be transferred to our PMC, who acts like a hub, and the hub spread this information to all the other locations.
So the file itself is transferred into the central hub, as we're calling it in this diagram.
Yep.
And then we're replicating out to our different data centers.
Correct.
Okay.
So the Excel sheet is placed in each data center. And when someone opens the Excel sheet here, this information will also be replicated to the other locations. And we will make sure that this file is locked.
Okay.
On the other locations. So if someone else tries to open the same document, like Mr. Miller has already opened in the UK, he get a message like the file is already opened by Mr. Miller. You can only open it in a read-only mode.
Okay, so Mr. Tiller, let's call him.
Okay.
Has the file open in the UK. And then Dennis comes along in Germany, tries to open my document, but you'll get the message to say it's read-only.
Correct.
Crystal clear.
Good. And now when you work on this file here, make some changes. The changes will be replicated to the other locations on a block level on a byte level base.
Okay, yeah. Yep.
And as soon as the file is closed, and all the information has been transferred, we release the file lock and you are able to open the file again in a read-write mode on another location.
Perfect. So the second I save my document and close it down, we're unlocking
Yes.
That same document in all the other data centers.
Correct.
Excellent.
Okay.
Perfect. That's great. So that's a great overview of the collaboration functionality that Peer Software are covering. Thanks for your time today.
You're welcome.
If you need any more information about Peer Software and what we can do, please contact Spectrami. Thank you.
Thank you.